rules of the exam. Examiners. Examiners are very cooperative and they try to help you as much as they can. With few exceptions in my case, only one or two out of 14 examiners. So don't think that he is trying to trap you unless you mention a fatal word or did a fatal mistake. I don't know is one of the key words in the exam. So don't hesitate to say I don't know. It happened with me three times during the whole exam, and they respect it unless this is mentioned in a basic knowledge. Also, it saves time for another questions, so you can perform better. Practice as much as you can. Classic clinical examination in your clinic. Before the clinical exam, because you need to show the examiner that this is your daily routine. Hands on. What I mean by hands-on, that you should try to attend subspecialty clinics in a major tertiary hospital, or arrange revision like Viva paced exams with your former past candidate in different subspecialties, so you can easily become familiar with the most common cases and how we can manage these cases practically. Here an advice from Steve Jobs, that don't let the noise of others' opinion drown out your own inner voice. So be confident. Don't afraid from anything. Whatever will happen in the exam, try to be confident. You may find the questions and scenarios simple and easy. Don't worry. Many questions in the exam will be like that. So suspicious feeling, try to avoid it. Although that any topic can be asked in the exam, it is possible to face any scenarios in the exam, especially Viva. So be ready. For example, in Delhi exam 2013, one of his slides in Viva was ankyloplephron. And also in my exam in Delhi 2014, I got a case of telecancer in the oculoplastic clinical station. So be ready. But this should make attention that there are common cases and scenarios that most probably will be asked during the exam. Prepare your answer prior to the exam. Expect the different scenarios and be ready, so you should achieve in these cases high pass. So this will help you to fill the defect if there is any mistakes in other difficult cases. In my point of view, the most useful thing in past candidate experience is their general advices and types of clinical cases in clinical examination. So focus on the cases that mentioned in your center. If you are appearing for Jordan exam, check cases in Jordan exam, and if Delhi exam, whatever. So it may give you some idea about different cases or strange cases that you can face there. Another important issue, that in any treatment, try to start by counseling, then conservative treatment, then surgical. Don't rush for surgery unless this is the only solution, like retinal detachment. In clinical exam, usually there is a very common cases that possibility of facing these cases are very high. So you must know these topics by heart. For example, in posterior segment diabetic retinopathy, it is a very common case. Ptosis, vein occlusion, proptosis, Duane syndrome, nerve palsy, third nerve palsy and sixth nerve palsy, whatever. And also keep calm. Don't panic if you missed one case in clinical, but avoid fatal cases and mistakes, and try to score high pass in the remaining cases. Double pathology is the rule. Also, in posterior segment situation, usually you should ask to I'd like to examine, ask the examiner that I'd like to examine the other eye, because there is a lot of cases that is a double bilateral pathology, retinitis pigmentosa, diabetic retinopathy, macular hole, all these things. So try to ask about examination. Here is a helpful material. This is a very useful video for indirect ophthalmology techniques, just to revise the basics, by Dr. Brian Little, who I think that he is one of the best teachers in UK. Also, this is another video on direct ophthalmoscopy. Oculoplastic station. There are very common cases in oculoplastic, like ptosis, proptosis, ectropion and entropion, lid mass, and atrophy pulpi. Sometimes they can bring it. Other common cases like nerve palsy, essential infantile esotropia, or accommodative esotropia, or intermittent AXT. There are some common cases, you should revise it. Anterior segment station. Anything can come at this station, but maybe corneal graft, maybe iris coroboma, maybe keratoconus, cyst like that, maybe patent PI, maybe corneal edema, maybe valve, whatever, maybe pigmentary glaucoma. But commonly these cases are very common. Corneal graft, corneal edema or failed graft, and destruction. This is U-turn sign. U-turn sign, you should return after each case, after finishing each case, to the 0 point. What I mean that if he asks you in the first case start by cornea, so in the second case you should make a U-turn, then start by conjunctiva. Conjunctiva, then cornea, then AC, then iris, then lens, and anterior vitreous face. This is why, because it's happened with me that in the second case, although he asked me to see from the cornea in the first case, in the second case, this was the case. Secondary inclusion conjunctival cyst, it was very peripheral in conjunctiva, and only the other finding was anterior chamber plus one cells. So if you are not if you didn't make a U-turn, you can miss this case easily. So start each case as a separate case. Also take care from slit lamp basics, because it will be very silly if they ask you in slit lamp basics and you forget or we cannot answer, like this focusing rod and also calibration of applanation tonometer. Also regarding state lamp filters, it will be a very bad mistake if you didn't answer any question about state lamp filters. You should know each filter, what is the name and for what we can use it. Like here, we should this gray filter that we can use in diffuse illumination for examination of the lid and the conjunctiva, also for examination of the fundus, heat absorption filter, open filter, and this is an space for accommodating any filter. And in some slit lamp, you can find instead of that the cobalt blue filter. Specular reflection is one of the technique, of the most difficult technique that you can adjust it in slit lamp, but at least you should know how you can do it. There is a useful link for a video about specular reflection technique in the YouTube is available here. Also scleretic scatter. I heard that they asked about it in former exams, how you can perform a scleretic scatter. Take care from missing important finding and important signs by not respecting systematic clinical examination. For example, I prefer to start examination by the conjunctiva. Okay, look straight, then up, then downward, look right, then left. So by this movement you can detect if there is blip, so surgical blip, or cyst, like in my case, in my exam in New Delhi, I faced a case like that. Okay, so you should follow systematic examination. Also take care that meticulous examination for subtle signs like vocal stridor. If you are not searching, if you don't search on these subtle signs, definitely you will miss it, like vocal stridor and Fuchs endothelial dystrophy. And this Fuchs endothelial dystrophy is very important in a case of failed graft. If you see a graft or whatever, or a failed graft, check the other eye, ask for examination of the other eye, because it may be the cause of the graft, or the cause of polyscleratopathy, or the cause of the corneal graft, whatever. So be meticulous. And this is a link of YouTube, in that YouTube, how about the Fuchs endothelial dystrophy. In Delhi exam, September 2013, one of my friends, got a case of pigment dispersion syndrome, and the AC was full of pigments. So if you didn't follow the systematic examination and you examine the AC as needed, turn off the light and increase the magnification, then you can check if there is cells or no, or flare. And also I remember in my case in New Delhi 2014, I got one case of plus one cells. There was plus one cells, and the examiner was very happy when I get this sign. Regarding iris, don't forget about rubeus iritis, because it is fatal. In every case, ask yourself if there is rubeus in the iris or not, because if you missed it, I know one of my friend failed in the exam because he missed rubeus iritis. So it is fatal. Also, one of the most common missed signs from most of the candidate, PI, patent PI. After checking grossly the iris, make a trans illumination to check if there is PI or not, like here. Easily you can miss the small PI if you are not examining by iris trans illumination. So trans illumination is a must. In anterior segment, not double pathology is the rule, as I mentioned before, but multiple pathology can be the rule. For example, this is a case I recorded by my camera in the clinic in our hospital. This case, you can see here, there is the arrow, this arrow is referred to, this is a case of DSIC, this means thriving in cellular keratoplasty. So here is the edge, so you will see, okay, there is a case of corneal graft DSIC, the lenticule in place, and then there is also the cornea, the graft is clear. Here is also, there is a posterior chamber IOL, and there is patches of iris atrophy. So I think this is sufficient. There are three findings. So why we are searching or complete our examination? No. But here is a patent PI, trans illumination defect. Again, trans illumination is mandatory. In Viva exam day, relax. Try one of the most important point, try to be, to act like you are examining a case in your clinic, and discuss with the examiner as if he is one of your colleague. He is asking your opinion in a case, not as an examiner. This just a worked example. Comment on this picture. You will say, okay, this is I can see a multiple corneal lesion. I cannot, it is here is granules and here is linear. So, involving the visual axis, and I cannot detect the level accurately, but it looks stromal level. So he will ask you, so what is your impression? You should answer, what about the other eye? He will tell you, okay, the other eye is the same finding. Oh, so if the other eye is the same finding, I am thinking in one of the corneal dystrophies. So what will be, what's your impression? If you know that this is a corneal dystrophy, this is Avellino dystrophy, this is a case of Avellino dystrophy. So you should mention the differential diagnosis according to the importance, like this is Avellino dystrophy, then lattice dystrophy, and then, but it doesn't look like granular. So you should avoid to put yourself in a trap. Don't mention the final diagnosis, mention a differential diagnosis. So he will ask you, what do you think the patient complain? He will answer, as it is involving the visual axis, so the main complaint will be visual defect or visual affection. And if there is, in some cases, it may cause recurrent corneal erosion, but mainly it will be visual. The last question he will ask you, how will you manage this patient? So ask the most important point here, that you ask the examiner, what about the vision of the patient, and what about the refraction of the patient? I want to ask about the visual needs of the patient, because it depends. According to the visual need, I'll decide. Okay, the patient is if the patient is happy with his vision, so I'll only manage him conservative. I'll prescribe a glasses, and he will use it. If the patient is not happy, okay, by his vision, so there are multiple options. First, I'll start by PTK. Okay, if the PTK is failed, I'll shift to anterior lamellar keratoplasty. So the last point, do you think that recurrence can occur after treatment? Yes, definitely recurrence can occur. So this is the left same patient, and the nightmares, only I'll mention this statements that I quoted from Dr. Samer Bashir experience. They announced the proceeding numbers after 30 hours, and only 17 made it from 56. Most of the fatalities were in general medicine, and a lot of good candidates were not among the list. It is very sad. You cannot prove yourself in the clinical unless you pass the non-ophthalmic stages. FRCS exam, there is two fate. Either if you passed, thanks to Allah, make the FRCS thinking as your standard in practice. Or if you failed, thanks to Allah also, as we are short-sighted and your suitable time will come soon. Try to correct your mistakes. And finally, remember that who walked along the trail arrived. Thanks for your attention.